Hi viewers, this is Suraj. This is my co-host Rakshita. We've come to north of Bangalore to Jakkur.
And here, Mrs. Sunaina has invited us to cook one of her favorite recipes. So let's get in and check out what she's cooking. Hi.
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 Thank you for inviting Siti Savari.
Welcome to my kitchen.
Thank you.
So what are you preparing for us today? I am expecting something yummy because of the weather outside.
Guess what? I am preparing everyone's favorite today with my own tweak to it. It's paneer butter masala.
I am using a pan, but you can use any type of kadhai you want. I'll be using 1 spoon of butter currently. Adding 1 spoon of oil to it so that it doesn't burn off. We'll be adding some spices. So we have to fry it a bit. You could add this to the main gravy itself, but I don't want the gravy to have any of these. I just want it to be very plain and simple. So I'm gonna add this here. Once it is still frying, you can add the saumph. Just adding 1 spoon of saumph into it. Saumph gives a different flavor. So you can also smell it. It'll be very nice. At this stage, because you want your paneer butter masala to be creamy, I'm going to add few cashews.
I can already smell something nice.
Yeah, that's because of the saumph and all the spices. So I have diced like 2 onions, medium sized onions, and you can add it even a little thicker if you want, because we are going to grind all of these anyways. So I did mention you about some tweaks, right? So I'm adding a lot of these spices which are not then the traditional paneer butter masala. So that gives you a lot of flavors. You have a lot of flavors coming up with that. Another one tweak is adding this guntur chili. That gives a distinctive spiciness which doesn't come through the normal green chilies. So I've added 4 of guntur chilies and 3 green chilies.
The way these spices and onions are getting together, they look very nice.
Yeah. So it's already done. We are taking this off the heat and allowing it to cool for some time before we grind this. So now I think it is cooled off. So I'll be transferring this to the mixie jar where we can grind it. This is the creamy texture we're looking for. So this should be very fine and there's no grainy texture to it. So we are preheating the pan again and we'll add 2 spoons of butter this time. And I'm just adding a little bit of oil so that the butter doesn't burn off. So once it's a little heated, we can add like 2 bay leaves to this. So now we'll be transferring the mixture we prepared. So once all the paste is transferred, we'll be cooking it under a medium flame. So we'll add a little bit of salt. At this point, we can just add a drizzle of it.
So you will do this according to taste, is it?
Yeah, according to your taste, yeah.
Okay, that's nice to know.
Also, I'm adding 1/2 spoon of ginger garlic paste to this. So while this is cooking, we will make a tomato puree. So in the meanwhile, I've taken like 4 medium-sized tomatoes and pre-blanched it to be able to skin it well. So we'll make that ready for the puree. And now we're going to be adding the tomato puree we just prepared. So we'll just bring this to a boil. Yeah, in between we keep adding a bit of butter, 1 or 2 spoons, throughout the dish. So now we'll be adding 1/2 spoon of Kashmiri lal mirch so we get the authentic taste and the color. I'm just adding like 1/4 spoon of garam masala powder to this. So I've taken around 250 grams of paneer and I've cut them into small cubes. You can vary the size according to your likings. And I'll be rinsing them into a hot water right now.
Why are we doing this?
So there are two reasons why we should do this. So the first one is it will make the paneer softer. And secondly, it will also remove the raw smell from the paneer.
Oh, this looks like another tweak.
Yeah, for sure it is. So now I'll be adding some salt to taste. So we can see it has all come to a boil, the gravy is boiling. Before we could add paneer, we'll just add 1 spoon of sugar so it enhances the flavor.
Nice.
So next we'll be adding 1/2 cup of cream and we'll add paneer after that. So one thing as a tip, in case you've added more spices, we can regulate that with the cream you add. So to finish this off, we'll just sprinkle a little bit of kasuri methi into this so it gives a nice aroma.
Oh, it smells great.
Yeah. Now the paneer is cooked, we'll turn off the stove and we'll be transferring it into a serving bowl. So this is my tweaked spicy paneer butter masala. It's ready. Let me know how it tastes.
The gravy is spicy, yummy and velvety.
The paneer is so soft and I can feel the whole spices flavor in it. Yummy.
Thanks a lot.
While we eat, please do
like and subscribe
City Safari.